cURL is a powerful command line tool for transferring data over various network protocols, including HTTP, HTTPS, FTP, and more. Naturally, due to the overwhelming popularity and convenience of Python, you may ask yourself, how do you use one with the other? Well, in this video, we'll aim to answer precisely that question. Although, if you'd like to learn more about cURL itself and why it piques the interest of numerous people, check out the What is cURL and What Does It Mean article in the description below. Now, let's jump straight into it. Python is known for its rich library ecosystem, so make sure to take advantage of these when using cURL. Some good examples are third-party libraries like requests and PycURL, which can provide more advanced features and better performance for handling some of the tasks we'll be looking at today. First, install the PycURL library. Once you do, you can use it to make a GET request and more. You can do this using pip, the package installer for Python. Write pip install PycURL. This command will download and install PycURL with its dependencies, allowing you to use the Python cURL commands. GET is a rather common request type. For example, when you enter a website, you are in fact sending a GET request. In turn, that page may send more GET requests to load images, style sheets, and other elements. For this tutorial, we'll be using this website, which is httpbin.org, which returns data in JSON with all the headers, data, form, and files found within the request. Moreover, this website accepts only post requests methods, while httpbin.org/get accepts GET requests. You can find the link to this website in our description below. Now, executing a GET request with PycURL is a rather straightforward process. If you use the cURL command and don't provide the X option, a GET request is sent by default. You can do the same thing using the PycURL library. In this example, we're creating a PycURL object, setting the URL option, and providing a buffer to store the response data. If we want to send a POST request with PycURL instead of GET, then use the following code. Here, we're creating a dictionary with the data we want to send, convert to a query string format, and setting the POST fields option to the prepared data. Now, having looked at basic GET and POST requests, we may also want to send custom HTTP headers. HTTP headers are used to provide additional information about a request or a response. Custom headers can also be included in GET requests, depending on your requirements. To send custom HTTP headers with a PycURL GET request, use the following code. In this example, we're creating a list of custom headers and setting the HTTP header option to this list. After executing the request, we close the PycURL object and print the response. We'll soon proceed to handling redirects, but before we do that, let's quickly look at sending JSON data with PycURL. After all, JSON is a popular format for exchanging data between clients and servers. To send data in a POST request using PycURL, see the following example. In the code example, we're converting the data dictionary to a JSON formatted string and setting the POST fields option to the JSON string. We're also setting the content type header with the intention of reforming the server that we're sending JSON data. Now, let's examine handling redirects. Crucially, PycURL can automatically follow HTTP redirects by setting the follow location option as shown here. To get only HTTP headers, you can set the header function option to custom function, which will process the received headers. So, having looked at multiple examples of sending requests, custom HTTP headers, and JSON data, you may start asking how do requests compare to PycURL? When it comes to choosing between the two, each library has its own strengths and weaknesses. PycURL is faster than requests, more powerful, flexible, and supports multiple protocols, but has a steeper learning curve and more verbose syntax. Requests, on the other hand, are easier to learn and use and contain more readable syntax and are generally better suited for simple tasks. However, Request is slower than PyCurl and supports only HTTP and HTTPS protocols. Basically, if you're looking for a simpler and more user-friendly library, you should probably go with Requests. However, if you prioritize performance and flexibility, PyCurl might be a better choice. PyCurl is also a useful library when it comes to web scraping. Although to perform web scraping tasks, you'll need additional libraries like Beautiful Soup or LXML. Also, PyCurl is particularly useful for web scraping tasks that require handling redirects, cookies, or custom headers. Typically, web scraping begins with a GET request for retrieving the HTML content of the target web page. Here's an example of web scraping with PyCurl and Beautiful Soup. In this example, we're using PyCurl to fetch the HTML content. Then we parse it with Beautiful Soup to extract the desired data. So, currently we've discussed the various steps you'd need to take to use CURL with Python and examine the use case of web scraping. However, what we haven't yet done is look through some of the errors you might encounter along the way. Therefore, let's take a look at them. Issue 1 may be import error for PyCurl and OpenSSL. In some cases, you may have an error in running the code with the libcurl library. It would look something like this. This error means that the OpenSSL headers are missing from your system. To fix this, use the following commands depending on your operating system. On macOS, install OpenSSL 1.1 with homebrew. Afterwards, reinstall PyCurl. On Windows, download and install the OpenSSL 1.1x binaries. You can find the download link in the description below. After that, add the following environment variables. Afterwards, install the Python library PyCurl and your code should now work. Issue 2 could be Unicode encoder error when sending non-ACI data. This error occurs when you try to send non-ACI characters in PyCurl request without properly encoding the data. To resolve this problem, make sure to encode the data using the appropriate character encoding before sending it with PyCurl as follows. Now, having gone through all the intricacies in this video, we're excited to hear how you've dealt with CURL using Python. If you have any questions or issues related to the matter, contact us at support@oxylabs.io. Thank you and see you next time.